delicious Singapore hawker food at Block 75 Toa Payoh. Welcome to another food adventure with Getting Lost. Today we're exploring more food like this delicious soup, this traditional snack that you can hardly find nowadays, this surprisingly good Western food, a bowl of noodles, and we are actually at Block 75, Lorong 5, Toa Payoh Food Center. Let's get eating! Let's start with how to get there. First of all, we are at Toa Payoh MRT station, which is on the north-south line, the red colour line, heading towards exit A. So once you get out of the gantry, you head out through these glass doors, turn left, then walk down the corridor, then turn left again, and go up this flight of escalator. Go up all the way to the top, and the first thing we're going to do is we're going to walk straight. Keep walking straight until we reach this place called Gourmet Paradise. Yes, so you turn left inside here. Now you take an escalator going down. We came here previously to eat the rojak. Okay, so you turn right, and the rojak is actually on our right here. As you can see, there's a long queue for the rojak. Just head down straight all the way to the other end. And we are here now at Haogang Mua Chi. The full name of the shop is actually called Haogang 6 Mile Famous Mua Chi. And Mua Chi is actually a snack that is slowly disappearing from our Singapore food scene. And this is one of those snacks that you will have to capture now before it's totally gone. Basically, Mua Chi is actually glutinous rice flour. Then they mix it up into a dough. And then with this dough, they will put in some oil. And then after that, coat it with either sesame seed or peanut. As you can see here, this is the peanut. This is the sesame seed. On the black color one, sesame seed. The texture here is nice and chewy and tender, which is good. And the seasoning itself is also not too sweet, especially the black sesame one. It has a very nice, fragrant black sesame taste that is very pleasing. The peanut one is a bit more sweet. I think he put a bit more sugar in that one. But overall, it's a very, very good snack. You should come here more often to try this, because once I think this shop closes, you'll be harder to find such snacks, and most places don't make it as good as he does. I really like the texture of the mochi. It's nice and tender, not too chewy, and it's totally delicious. So you have to come here and try. We're actually back out again at the escalator coming up from the MRT station. We are going back to Berth B2 to take bus 235. Okay, and this time we are taking it to the 6th bus stop from the interchange. So it's bus 235 at the 6th bus stop, and this is the 6th bus stop itself. It's the bus stop at Block 59. So this is the bus stop itself that you get off at, and if you actually look across the road, there's actually a block over there. So we're going to cross the road here, then take the covered walkway over here, and then after that we're going to walk under the block and head towards that direction, because at the next block there's actually some eateries at the bottom of the block there. and we're going to try one of the eateries there. We're going to try some food there from this place called Uno Beef House. They are well known for their Western food. And here is the items that they sell together with the prices. And this is the shop itself. They call this Uno Beef House. And what I ordered itself was the chicken cutlet, which cost me $7. Okay, look at the chicken itself. It's actually quite nicely fried. I think they actually put a layer of seasoning and batter on top before they deep fry the chicken itself. And then you have garlic bread, fries, coleslaw, and beans. And if you look at the meat itself, you can see how juicy it is. And it is really juicy. It is really tender. They did a really good job with the meat. The chicken cutlet here, superb. It's nice. It takes very little effort to cut the meat using your knife. And itself tastes very good, very juicy, very tender. The coleslaw also done very well. Fresh vegetables, a nice thick mayonnaise. Very good. Overall, a very good Western food. If you like Western food, you should come here and give it a try. Very good. The other items are just normal. So we are back at the bus stop at block 59. This time we're going to walk down the other direction. Okay. So from that bus stop, we're going to walk down all the way to this place here, which is actually block 75, Lorong 5, Toa Payoh. This is another food center here along the road, and we're going to eat some food here. Yes, this is another small food center surrounded by very, very old HDB blocks. Some of the blocks here are actually were the first few blocks that were actually made, which were actually erected in Toa Payoh. Nearby here, not exactly at this location, but nearby here. So this is a very interesting food center, and we're gonna go in here and eat the food. The first food we're going to try at this food center is at this place here called Songgi Kway Teow Noodle Soup. They actually sell fishball noodles here. You can have it either dry or soup. Okay, so you just go over there and you tell them what's your preference. Okay, and then you just make payment and just wait for them to prepare the noodles for you. What I ordered was the small portion, which is 350 dry noodles. First of all, the noodles are done okay, but it is covered with a very thick red sauce that is not very spicy, but more like savory kind of sauce, and it's a bit oily, but the oiliness comes from pork lard. There's lots of pork lard here, especially the pork lard oil, and if you like the pork lard taste, this noodles is for you. What I really like about here is the fish balls and the fish cake here. They do it very, very well, very delicious. One of the better fish balls and fish cake I had around. But I felt that the noodles itself was a bit bland because it's a bit oily and a bit bland. But the fish cake, the fish balls, very well done, very delicious. And finally, we are at the fish soup shop. And this shop sells very good fish soup. Okay, first of all, you look at the board there. There's a different types of fish soup you can order. You also can order different type of fish. You can order salmon and also red snapper if you want, and also different types of seafood. But I just ordered normal sliced fish soup, which cost me $4.50. Extra 50 cents for the rice. First of all, the soup here is really, really good. I really, really like the soup here. It has a very nice, clean, refreshing seafood soup taste, mostly fish taste, with a like a Chinese preserved vegetable and cilantro aftertaste after that. Overall, very, very well done. They also have minced meat in the soup itself, together with the sliced fish. The sliced fish, also very good. It is fresh, it has a nice texture, firm texture to eat when you bite into it. And this place is also healthy because they give you lots and lots of vegetables together with your soup. The soup, like I said, very well done, full flavored, very delicious, and goes very well with the rice. It was a good idea for me to order the rice because the rice and the soup goes very well together. Overall, this is actually one of the better fish soups that I've eaten in Singapore. So if you do like fish soup, you should come down here and try this. So this is our food adventure so far. We have been to Block 75, Lorong 5, Toa Payoh Food Center. And this is a good food center, even though it's small, there's still some good food here that you can try. And as per usual, I need you to like, share and subscribe. If you're not done so, get your friends and family members to do so. And don't forget to click the bell button also to get your notification. I've heard that if you don't do that, you don't get regular updates about my newest videos. And finally, the most important thing, please join me for my next food adventure. That's the most important thing. And bye-bye.